Welcome to the Ira A. Fulton Schools of Engineering at Arizona State University. Our college houses the undergraduate and graduate degree programs for engineering, computer science, and a majority of the technology programs that are offered at ASU. This presentation will explore the mechanical engineering degree program with a concentration in computational mechanics. ASU has four campuses that span the Phoenix metro area, and the Fulton Schools of Engineering are located on two of those, the Tempe campus and the Polytechnic campus. The degree programs within the School for Engineering of Matter, Transport, and Energy, also known as SEMPTE, are located at the Tempe campus, but all campuses are open to all students regardless of where their program is located. We offer a free intercampus shuttle for our students so that they can explore courses, student orgs, activities, and resources at any campus. At Fulton, we offer 25 undergraduate degree programs, which provides a lot of choice and flexibility in finding the program that fits for you. We are called the Fulton Schools of Engineering because we categorize our degree programs into six schools, which are organized by theme and location. The first five schools from left to right are housed at the Tempe campus, and the Polytechnic School is housed at the Polytechnic campus. Our mechanical engineering students belong to the School for Engineering of Matter, Transport, and Energy, which you will see towards the right of the infographic. Each school has its own director, affiliated faculty, and advising unit so as to provide greater support and specific guidance to the students within that school. ASU and Fulton have direct admission, meaning when students apply, they apply directly to the degree program they want to pursue. As long as a student meets the admissions criteria for their program of interest, they are admitted. It is important to note that some of the degree programs, including mechanical engineering, have slightly higher admissions criteria than the general university requirements. For a comprehensive list of admissions criteria, you can visit the Fulton Schools of Engineering website at engineering.asu.edu. Students in SEMPTE are located at the Tempe campus, which is both their academic and residential home. First-year freshmen are expected to live on campus their first year, and our SEMPTE students are currently registering for housing in the Tooker House. Tooker House is the residential hall for all of the engineering disciplines, and we are also expanding to the University House for the 2020-2021 academic year. Students that are a part of Barrett the Honors College live in Barrett housing, but are given the opportunity to live on an engineering-specific floor if they choose.
The concentration in computational mechanics under the BSE program in mechanical engineering is designed to teach students the modern computational tools available for solving large-scale and complex technical programs. As mathematical and numerical modeling takes on a larger role in product development, graduates who are highly skilled in computational and mathematical engineering will be in high demand. The curriculum focuses on high-performance computing and the accurate modeling of large and small-scale systems. Students in the undergraduate program get to cultivate an understanding behind a diverse range of operations while developing skills needed to produce hands-on results for their community and abroad. As you can see on the major map, the BSE in Mechanical Engineering with Computational Mechanics is 120 credits, much of which is math or science-based. Students in this program will take Calculus 1, 2, and 3, as well as differential equations and elementary linear algebra. Students will also take Chemistry and Physics 1 and 2. In the second year of this program is when students start taking Mechanical Engineering courses. The prefix for these are MAE and MEE. The first year is general education courses, which provide a solid foundation for this program. Students are required to take 15 credits of humanities and social behavioral courses. As students move into the second half of the program, they will get to choose their computational technical elective courses, which allow them to branch off in areas of interest within the program. The accelerated degree, often referred to as the 4+1, allows students to share up to 12 credits between graduate and undergraduate programs, allowing students to complete a master's degree in 1 year. This saves students time and money and eliminates the need for the graduate readiness exam, also known as the GRE. This program has agreements in place that allow students to choose a master's in either mechanical engineering, aerospace engineering, or materials science and engineering. Students apply for this program when they are completing MAE 318, MEE 342, and MEE 323, and must have a 3.5 GPA in all courses applying to their degree audit report. The Mechanical Engineering and Computational Mechanics program offers opportunities to impact technological advances through working in a team environment with engineers from material science, electrical, chemical, aerospace, and other engineering disciplines. Students in this program are in demand in a wide range of industries and professions, including aerospace, automotive, biomedical, energy, and supply chain.
Hello everyone, my name is Madison Walker. I'm a current senior studying mechanical engineering on the Tempe campus, born and raised in Phoenix, Arizona. First, I'd like to start and mention that I do not have the concentration in computational mechanics. However, I've had exposure to a lot of its applications, and I see the value in specializing in computational mechanics in the engineering field. So first, I'll give you a brief overview of my student org experience, and then I'll move on to talk about how this concentration can be helpful in real life projects. So I am the current president of Fulton Ambassadors on the Tempe campus. I am an active member of the Society of Women Engineers. I'm a member of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, and I am a member of the Next Generation Service Corps at ASU. So all of these kind of relate to various things that I'm interested in. Fulton Ambassadors does K-12 engineering outreach. Society of Women Engineers has given me the opportunity to network with other students that are passionate about diversity in the workplace. And I've also gotten to meet some really awesome female engineers that work at Honeywell, Intel, Texas Instruments. So it's been a great opportunity for me to develop myself as a female engineer. As a part of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, I've had the opportunity to attend a competition where we had to design a hovercraft that was made out of 3D materials and that had to simulate what a hovercraft would have to do when distributing care packages during times of disaster. So as a part of ASME, I've really gotten to see the impact that mechanical engineers can have on the safety and the security of our community. And last, I'm a part of the Next Generation Service Corps. This isn't specific to Fulton. This is actually something that's ASU-wide, but I always like to mention it because in this program, I've gotten to develop as a leader. I've gotten to develop professionally, and I've also gotten to work with students that are in different disciplines than me while working on hands-on projects that work towards a common goal. So if any of those pique your interest, I definitely encourage you to look those up on the website. So now I'd like to talk a little bit about the application of this computational mechanics concentration. So something that is unique about this computational mechanics concentration, as you've seen in the major maps, is you get to take more classes that will allow for you to take some classes that are more suited towards modeling. Maybe it's 3D modeling, maybe it's modeling through software, but this is very applicable in mechanical engineering, and I'll really tell you why. If you think about when you're working on a project or when you want to solve some sort of problem, I think there's a lot of different ways that you can do that. And one of the ways that you can do that is by prototyping. So you can buy the materials, you can build something, see if it works. If it doesn't work, then you have to go and buy new materials and then build again and see if it works. And if it doesn't, you kind of go through that cycle. And one way to really make sure that you're using your time wisely and that you're using your resources is by actually doing a lot of these modeling on these models on computer software. So I have worked on some projects in my curriculum that have gotten me exposure to that. In mechanical engineering, you have to take classes where you learn about MATLAB, you learn how to use SolidWorks, you learn how to use ANSYS, and all of these tools will help you in modeling and really predicting failure before it actually happens. One example of that is if you take a car, let's say that you're designing a vehicle and you need to determine the diameter of the axle. The axle is what is connected to the wheels, right? So the car can't go if there isn't an axle there. But if the weight of the car is too heavy, then that axle is going to snap and you're not going to be able to move the car. So I've actually taken a class where we had to, we had all of these different components. We had the gear train, we had them connected to various components, but we had to use anything at our disposal to determine what that minimum shaft diameter would have to be in order for it to not break under the pressure of the system that was on top of it. And MATLAB, one of the things that you learn in your classes, is really a great way to determine that. You can build a code that's going to do that work for you. You can use MATLAB to create different graphs that will show you temperature distribution across a material. You can use SOLIDWORKS and ANSYS to build a part and then transfer it into ANSYS to do stress analysis in it to see where it's going to fail. So there's a lot of different applications of this. And I think that if you're wanting to really get into that field, you really like number crunching, you really like obviously problem solving, it's really great to do this computational mechanics concentration because it's going to prepare you well for the jobs in the industry that are going to let you do that. I have previous internship experience at the Boeing company, and I did not work in an aerospace engineering role, but one of the other departments that was there, they hired on a bunch of mechanical engineers that would do stress engineering on the Apache helicopter. So they would need to use those classes that that you would be taking in computational mechanics to really see if the helicopter would buckle under the weight of the other components, determine if the propellers of the helicopter are actually useful, if it's made out of the right material. So there's definitely a lot of different applications in automotive and biomedical engineering, really all across the board. So if any of the stuff I've talked about right now sounds interesting to you, then computational mechanics in mechanical engineering might be the right program for you.
Thank you for taking this time to explore the Ira A. Fulton Schools of Engineering. If you have any questions about applying to Fulton, please contact us at fultonschools@asu.edu. If you have any specific questions about the degree program covered in this presentation, please contact us at sempd@asu.edu.